हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर ऑन इवापोट्रांसपिरेशन। व्हाट इज ट्रांसपिरेशन? ट्रांसपिरेशन इज द प्रोसेस बाय विच वाटर लीव्स द बॉडी ऑफ अ लिविंग प्लांट एंड रीचेस द एटमॉस्फेयर एज वाटर वेपर। द वाटर इज टेकन अप बाय द प्लांट रूट सिस्टम एंड एस्केप्स थ्रू द लीव्स। द इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग ट्रांसपिरेशन आर एटमॉस्फेरिक वेपर प्रेशर, temperature, wind, light intensity and characteristics of plant such as the root and leaf system. For a given plant, factor that affect the free water evaporation also affect transpiration. However, a major difference exists between transpiration and evaporation. Transpiration is essentially confined to daylight hours and the rate of transpiration depends upon the growth periods of the plant. Evaporation, on the other hand, continues all through the day and night, although the rates are different. Evapotranspiration. While transpiration takes place, the land area in which plants stand also lose moisture by the evaporation of water from soil and water bodies. In hydrology and irrigation practice, it is found that evaporation and transpiration processes can be considered advantageously under one head as evapotranspiration. The term consumptive use is also used to denote this loss by evapotranspiration. For a given set of atmospheric conditions, evapotranspiration obviously depends on the availability of water. If sufficient moisture is always available to completely meet the needs of vegetation fully covering the area, the resulting evapotranspiration is called potential evapotranspiration. I will repeat this sentence. If sufficient moisture is always available to completely meet the needs of vegetation fully covering the area, the resulting evapotranspiration is called potential evapotranspiration. Potential evapotranspiration no longer critically depends on the soil and plant factors, but depends essentially on the climatic factors. The real evapotranspiration occurring in a specific situation is called actual evapotranspiration and denoted by letter AET. Field capacity and permanent wilting point. It is necessary to introduce at this stage two terms, that is field capacity and permanent wilting point. Field capacity is the maximum quantity of water that the soil can retain against the force of gravity. Any higher moisture input to a soil at field capacity simply drains away. Permanent wilting point is the moisture content of a soil at which the moisture is no longer available in sufficient quantity to sustain the plants. At this stage, even though the soil contains some moisture, it will be so held by the soil grains that the roots of the plants are not able to extract it in sufficient quantities to sustain the plants, and consequently the plants wilt. The field capacity and permanent wilting point depend upon the soil characteristics. The difference between these two moisture contents is called available water. The moisture content available for plant growth. Now, the measurement of evaporation. The measurement of evapotranspiration for a given vegetation type can be carried out in two ways, either by using lazy meters or by use of field plots. So, what is lazy meter? A lazy meter is a special watertight tank containing a block of soil and set in a field of growing plants. The plants grown in the lazy meter are the same as in the surrounding field. Evapotranspiration is estimated in terms of amount of water required to maintain constant moisture conditions within the tank, measured either volumetrically or gravimetrically through an arrangement made in the lazy meter. Lazy meters should be designed to accurately reproduce the soil conditions, moisture content, type and size of the vegetation of the surrounding area. They should be so buried that the soil is at the same level inside and outside the container. Lysimeter studies are time consuming and expensive. So for your reference, this is the picture of lysimeter which is taken from internet. Vegetation is grown inside the lysimeter like this. Then field plots. In special plots, all the elements of the water budget in a known interval of time are measured, and the evapotranspiration is determined as evapotranspiration is equal to precipitation plus irrigation input minus runoff minus increase in soil storage minus groundwater loss. Measurements are usually confined to precipitation, irrigation input, surface runoff and soil moisture. Groundwater loss due to deep percolation is difficult to measure and can be minimized by keeping the moisture condition of the plot at the field capacity. This method provides fairly reliable results. For the sake of understanding, this is the picture taken from an internet source which shows the field plots for the measurement of evapotranspiration. Then by using some evapotranspiration equations also, we can estimate the quantities of evapotranspirations, like Penman's equation. Penman's equation is based on sound theoretical reasoning and is obtained by a combination of energy balance and mass transfer approach. Penman's equation incorporating some of the modifications suggested by other investigator is PET is equal to A into H suffix N plus Ea into gamma divided by A plus gamma, where PET is equal to daily potential evapotranspiration in mm per day, A is equal to slope of saturation vapor pressure versus temperature curve at the mean air temperature in mm of mercury per degree Celsius, capital H suffix N is equal to net radiation in mm of evaporable water per day, capital E suffix A is equal to parameter including wind velocity and saturation deficit, G is equal to psychometric constant which is equal to 0.49 mm of mercury per degree Celsius. The net radiation is the same as used in the energy budget. Then Blaney-Criddle formula. This purely empirical formula is based on data from arid western United States. This formula assumes that the PET is related to hours of sunshine and temperature, which are taken as measures of solar radiation at an area. The potential evapotranspiration in a crop growing season is given by ET is equal to 2.54 K into F, where F is equal to summation of pH TF bar divided by 100, where ET is equal to potential evapotranspiration in a crop season in centimeter. Capital K is equal to an empirical coefficient depends on the type of crop and stage of growth. F is equal to sum of monthly consumptive use factors for the period. Capital P suffix H is equal to monthly percent of annual daytime hours depends on the latitude of the place, and T bar suffix F is equal to mean monthly temperature in degree Fahrenheit. Values of capital K depends on the month and locality. Then second empirical formula is Thornwaite formula. This formula was developed from data of eastern USA and uses only the mean monthly temperature together with an adjustment for day lengths. The potential evapotranspiration is given by this formula as E suffix T is equal to 1.6 LA into bracket 10 T bar divided by I suffix T whole bracket raised to A, where ET is equal to monthly PET in centimeter, that is potential evapotranspiration in centimeters. L suffix A is equal to adjustment for the number of hours of daylights and days in the month related to the altitude of the place. By using these formulae, you can find out the potential evapotranspiration. For any further explanation and several numericals. I request all of you to go through the standard references which I have enlisted over here. If you find any difficulty, you can ask me on my email address as dnpaitankarce@sanjeevani.org.in. Thank you for listening. Happy learning.